forests are the lungs of the planet and the world's air conditioning system. We're on the verge of switching it off.
There is no business in the future unless biodiversity is looked after.
Local knowledge is sometimes taken for granted, but this is lived experience.
So through practices such as agroforestry, which is growing crops among trees and trees among crops, we can address a societal challenge in a way that brings benefits locally for people and biodiversity.
Agroforestry is the oldest form of farming known to man. It's the art and the science of adding perennial plants like trees to a farming system.
Restoring natural forests will give an opportunity to restore the lost biodiversity and have some new biodiversity come into the area.
In Ghana, the deforestation, we have created low soil nutrients, land degradation, fire, poverty, unemployment. We have supplied about 23 communities, fruit trees, indigenous trees. The project seeks to plant about 4,500 hectares.
We have more than 9,000 hectares of eucalyptus planted on our plantations and 2,000 hectares of indigenous trees planted on our plantation as well.
Trees provide protection against pest and disease. Trees can find nutrients much deeper in the soil than crop roots can. They also offer resilience against drought. They offer resilience against storms and against soil erosion. There's the wood, there's fruits, there's nuts, there's fodder, there's medicinals.
Abuami, ama mikuya yeni mumu asisa, ama minye kuya eba kum, midya niema efrafra, abro bees mako, edifra ekan cashew diano. First, na biya midi spraying machine, ene bo adro nu ewo cashew nasi ebuano. First na yedya ni abo spray. The same zua yedya cashew nu yebedra asi.
Business relies on biodiversity. Supply chains are at high risk. Bringing together, you know, knowledge from experiments and observational studies is really critically important. We have to work with communities from the bottom up.
We can change the way farming is being done to improve the deal for biodiversity and the climate and still produce the food, the fiber, the timber, and so on that a growing humanity will need in a warming world. And by happy coincidence, the way to do that is by boosting the biodiversity of the farming system.
Podemos aumentar la biodiversidad en la producción de cacao introduciendo nuevas plantas de otros orígenes genéticos. Pueden ser también árboles maderables como sombra permanente y musáceas como sombra temporal. El cacao se adapta bien a la agrosilvicultura porque tiene la capacidad de combinarse con otros cultivos. Pueden ser, además del cacao criollo, actualmente se están realizando huertos agrícolas donde se cultivan otras hortalizas como pimentón, ají y cebollín, para luego estas ser distribuidas entre los trabajadores y las comunidades vecinas.
Brilliant grassroots organizations can channel finance from the corporate sector to tailor different interventions to that local context.
Project Giri Pragati is the adoption of regenerative agriculture-based farming. Participating farmers integrate the flora and fauna that is available as a part of farming systems. It provides a uniqueness in the type of spices that are produced in this region.
They grow coffee, pepper, turmeric, ginger. Turmeric, it's a local variety. The reason it has got so much uniqueness of having more curcumin content. It has got a lot of demand in the market. Black pepper is not a single crop. It is being grown as an intercrop in coffee. on one hand, we are able to improve the productivity. On the other hand, we are able to improve the quality. Thereby, better returns to the farmers.
ఎంత పంటలు వేసుకోవడం వల్ల ఆదాయం వస్తుంది?
అదే ఆ రాబడి వచ్చిన డబ్బుతో మరి పిల్లల్ని చదివించుకుంటూ.
It's time that we all work together, the investors, the project developers, the local leaders and policy makers and local communities, to collaborate together to actually come up with transformative projects that transform communities into communities that live in harmony with nature, to communities that have alternative livelihoods to support the economy, that support the society and the environment.
By doing this, you improve the productivity of that land, you improve the profits of those farmers. So it's a win-win. It's an obvious win-win. The evidence is in, and we should be rolling up our sleeves and doing it as opposed to talking about it.